A Frostburg State University graduate student is digging deep into the history of Cranberry Swamp in Finzel. Hidden behind this picturesque mountain valley in Garrett County is a muck with some built-in mystery. This swamp could reveal the story of what plants flourished centuries ago in this unique terrain.
Finzel is a frost pocket. It sits in the valley between two ridges, the Big Savage Mountain and Little Savage Mountain.
That frost pocket creates an area with temperatures more akin to parts of Canada than the Appalachian Mountains, which is what attracted Jade Llewellyn to this swamp.
I actually like being out here muddy and using the drill to get it down into the soil and extract out the sediment cores.
Llewellyn is joined by Dr. Phil Allen from FSU's Geography Department as they use equipment for Frostburg's new geochemistry lab to complete her research.
The thing that Jade will be looking at primarily is pollen, and because the pollen describes the vegetation, and once you see vegetation changing, there has to be a reason for it changing, whether that's a climatic or a human input, those kind of things. So we're trying to see how it's changed and also try and see if there's any signal of why it changed.
The 1,000-year-old history of it, I don't think that no one's ever looked into it to do what we're trying to do out here.
Llewellyn is obtaining her master's degree in applied ecology and conservation through a collaboration with both the biology and geography departments. In the field, Llewellyn is collecting those 1,000-year-old organic samples by using a powerful cushion hammer along with a coring system made by a small family business in Germany.
We're actually using a system called a Stitz closed-chambered piston core, which means we can push this down to whatever depth we want and then open it and collect samples so there's no contamination. And that came through an Appalachian Regional Commission grant application that myself and Bob Larravee in chemistry wrote to develop a geochemistry laboratory on site. And before we can do any geochemistry, we have to get samples out of the ground. So part of that equipment was a coring system.
Once the pollen samples are processed and Llewellyn completes her study, her findings are expected to help the Nature Conservancy, who owns and manages the land, to create special management plans for the swamp. This hands-on experience coupled with a new geochemistry lab will become valuable for creating jobs for students in Western Maryland.
Really do get the hands-on learning. As an undergrad, I went to Frostburg as well, and then I had an internship with the USGS, and you know, it relates directly to what you would be doing in a job and in the field.
If we train our students, many of whom want to stay in this area, at least they've got the skills for the future to try and preserve the kind of environment we have.
A path to a successful career can be a challenging one, let alone a physical one, as Llewellyn has found out.
It's like walking through quicksand and getting stuck, falling on your butt a lot in the mud. It took about 3.5 hours to drag all of this equipment out yesterday, even though it might be about 1.5 to 2 mile hike in, which takes no time if you're not bogged down by all the equipment.
For more information, visit frostburg.edu.
Perfect.
No way.
Yep, 3 times I'm a champion.